Hello, this is Tola from Trifle Productions with another Blender Quick Tip. And in this Quick Tip, I'm going to show you how you can use the old version of prolighting skies in Blender 2.8. Now, I don't know if they've released a new version of prolighting skies from Blender Guru for 2.8, but the old version only works for 2.79 and older, I guess, versions, but for 2.8, it's a whole completely different format. Or script for 2.8, so prolighting skies will not work in 2.8. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go into, I've already extracted it, but go into where you've saved your add-on. I've saved mine in an external hard drive, and you're going to want to extract it. Let me navigate down to it. Just click on that. Right-click and extract files. I use WinRAR to extract it from the zip file, which I've already done, which is right here. And then you're going to open up that file, and you're going to navigate to the HDRIS folder, and you're going to see all of that, everything that's contained inside of that add-on, which are the images, the thumbnails, the resolutions, EXR files. This is what you're going to have to transfer over to the internal version of Blender 2.8 in order to have it work in 2.8. And I've done that also. And in order to navigate to where you saved that version of Blender on your computer, I've changed my logo for Blender 2.8, because I think it's a new piece of software, so I've made it look different, the logo look different. But once you've hovered over the Blender icon on your desktop, left click on that, or right click on it, then go to, let me see, Open File Location, which is this right here. And then you're going to go into 2.8 to double click on that. Data Files, double click on that. Studio Lights, double click on that, open that up, and then World, double click on that. And you're going to highlight everything that says EXR in the Prolighting Skies folder. And you're going to, once everything's been highlighted, you don't need the images at all, you just need the EXR files. And once you've clicked and dragged and selected all of these, you're going to left click and hold down your left mouse button, drag it over. And I've already done this also, and it's already been transferred over to the world file for Blender 2.8. And then you're going to open up Blender 2.8. Now this only works or shows up in the look dev shader. So we're going to go into camera view by pressing 0 on our keyboard. And I'm going to give this a shader here. Let me see. Let me go to the shader tab. Use nodes. And I'm going to turn up the specular. And turn down the roughness so it can be as shiny as possible. Then I'm going to click on this button here. This says Look Dev. Click on that. And you can see that it's shiny, and what it's doing is it's reflecting the default worlds onto this cube. Let me see if we can make it shinier. Okay, there we go. So now it's reflecting what's in the default world view of the HDR. In order to use prolighting skies instead of the default HDRs that come with Blender, you're going to click on this little arrow, drop an arrow, and you'll see this ball here. Once you click on that ball, then this might take a little bit of time because I'm running the Camtasia at the same time, so it might take a little time to load up. But it should open up. That's why it's also taking a long time, because here it is. These are all the shaders, all the HDR images from Prolighting Skies. And here they all are. You can, you know, once they're all loaded up, if you hover over any of them, it'll tell you which HDR image it is. And I'm just going to click on the one with clouds on it. Click on that. And then it shows up in your scene. Let's press zero to go back to camera view. Now, the only thing with this is that it won't show up, or it won't render out as an image in your scene at all. It'll just show up, because this is a look dev. I think look dev means the development mode of a game engine. That's what this is. But if you wanted to show up in an actual scene that you render, what you're going to have to do is go to the world, excuse me, the Eve renderer, click on that. And you're going to divide up your UI, your scene here. Sorry, I've got the weather is kind of bothering me a little bit. It's affecting my voice a little bit. But once you split up your window, click on that icon and go to Shade Editor. And here, you're going to go into the World tab. And then we're going to press X. We don't want to use the default gray background for Blender, so press X to delete that. And then press Shift A. And you're going to go down to Texture. And in Texture, you're going to choose Environment Texture. Let's do that again, Shift A. Texture, Environment Texture. Click on that. Drag that up. Connect that. I think it's going to turn pink because it doesn't know what we're going to use in terms of an HDRI image for the environment. And click on open. And what you're going to do is you're going to go to that folder that you just extracted. So I'm going to highlight all that and press Control C. Go back into Blender, click on that, press Control V and press Enter. And let's have a visual of what we're looking at here. And this will show you the images that you can use from Prolighting Skies in your scene. And you're going to still click on the EXR file format here, not the JPEG. The JPEG you can use, but sometimes those come out pretty blurred, so you really don't want to use that in a final render. So I'm going to click on, let me see, this cloudy one down below, EXR. Cloud 02 and click open image and give that a few minutes. Okay, it did it. And press 0 on your keyboard, and if you look around you can see that the sky from Prolighting Skies is now in your scene. And so that's how you can use Prolighting Skies, the old version of it, in 2.8 until they make a new version of Prolighting Skies for 2.8. But that's my quick tip for today. Hope I was able to help someone, and sorry for my clearing my throat over the mic. It's just the weather. But yes, that's how you can use Prolighting Skies and Blender 2.8. Hope this was helpful, and see you guys on the next one. Have a great evening. All right, bye.